Dana Stevens Show. Let's go. Check it. Don't forget about love, joy, peace. Let's talk about it with Dana. That's what the world needs. Let's put away the hatred, racism, and greed. And tune into your dialogue with Dana Steve. Yo. From Chi-Town to Florida to A-Town, DMP got sick of our people falling down. PD gotta stop the violence in all towns. This is what we call awareness, time to spread around. We got a legendary activist going viral. And me, I'm quarterback and spitting these flows like spirals. Like Colin Kaepernick kneeling to God in every show. And late night appealing to God for us to grow. These demonic politicians have really got to go. That's how it started, right here on radio. Don't forget about love, joy, peace. Let's talk about it with Dana.
Hello to all of you out there in social media world. This is Brother Dana coming to you from, you know it, Chicago. I am dirty. I've been outside cleaning and doing some yard work and all different stuff. And anytime I do anything, I'm always got my mind on the Most High Yah and listening to his music and worshiping him. And tonight, as I was just listening randomly to some of my music, this song came up. And this, when this song came up, it penetrated me so much that I had to come in to get myself a little bit together. But then to just not keep it to myself, but bring it to you. And so I'm going getting together a few scriptures. And I know I have been, you know, talking with you about my journey with the Most High Yah and really finding out what it is that he desires of me. What does he desire of me? What is it he wants me to do? I'm not talking about his will per se. I'm talking about what is it he wants from me that will let him know that I love him and I'm devoted to him. And when this song hit me tonight, it hit me so powerfully that I am sitting before you right now to share this with you.
What is the sacrifice that you desire, Lord? Clean hands and pure heart, that's what you're looking for. More than a song, more than a melody, you want a heart submitted, a life committed to you. That's what I'll bring. And here is all I need. And here's my offer. What is the sacrifice that you desire, Lord? Clean hands and pure heart, that's what you're looking for. You are more than a song and more than a melody. You want a heart. submitted, aligned, committed to you. That's what I'll bring. Here is all I need. Jesus, and here is.
That song struck me because in this journey, as I have been sharing, I have been wrestling with the law and following the law and then looking at the life of Yeshua HaMashiach.
Hey, I created this.
And so in that, it's like what the Most High Yah desires is us. And tonight when I was doing the work, some neighbors came over and some of the kids came by, and must have been a family member that wasn't always present. And they were coming over to see my dogs. And the one family member said, oh, don't go over by his dog. And I heard the lady say, oh no, it's okay. He's, you know, he's a nice white guy. And I look at the blessings of the Most High Yah, and it humbled me, because shortly after that, the song came, and it humbled me. Because what it just seems like is when we follow the law, it doesn't cause one to fall to the feet of Yeshua HaMashiach. Because there's a part of you, and I saw this in my people, that there's a part of them that believes, as my grandpa said, that when you follow the Ten Commandments and you do what they tell you to do, that is why we as white people have what we have. And when you look at other minorities, they don't have what they don't have or we have because they're lazy and because they're not following the Ten Commandments like we do. And there became an arrogance in that. There was no sort of compassion or empathy for anybody that failed as we see it being somebody who fails without looking beyond the law to understand that the law and what is happening in our country is not righteous and fair. And the law does not build a relationship with the individual that's behind the law. You follow the law so you don't get caught. Yeah, you may love God, but when you get to a point that everything that I'm not facing in my life, how dare I take credit because I followed the law? Because it has been His grace and His mercy and His unconditional love for me that has wooed me to my knees of humility and has showed me that if I want to be the way the Most High Yah wants me to be, then I must try to fill the shoes that Yahshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, walked in. Let no debt remain outstanding except the continuing debt to love one another. For whoever loves others has fulfilled the law, the commandments. You shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and whatever other command there may be are summed up in this one command: love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no harm to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfillment of the law. In Luke, Yahshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, answered and said, you must love the Most High Yah with all your heart and your soul and your strength and your mind. And then love your neighbor as yourself. But without faith, Hebrews 11:6, it is impossible to please Him. For he that cometh to Yah must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek after Him. If the law was sufficient, if the law was equipped, would we be in what we are in today? And I look from you as my Hebrews that say, out of rebellion for the law and not following it, you went into. And then I look at my people, and we have been so full of law that we have been arrogant in that. That's why we are supreme, because we have held the law over you. We followed it. You haven't, and that's why you are where you are. But when the Spirit of humility and love and falls on you, when you experience the goodness of the Most High Yah, it drops you to your knees, and there at your knees, how dare you judge anyone? And then you are to walk in the shoes like Yahshua did. And He walked to those with leprosy. He walked to the blind. He walked to the Samaritans. He walked to the adulterous woman. And there at their feet, He heard their cry. He heard their story. Yahshua HaMashiach, and this is a verse that the Most High has given me to give me strength. And He said, the Roman centurion who came to my son, Yahshua out of his mouth said, not have I seen this kind of faith even amongst Israel. And it solidified to me that I can be embraced by the Most High Yah through his son Yahshua HaMashiach, even as an absolute stranger or Gentile. Because that Roman centurion was the enemy, the governmental enemy of Yahshua HaMashiach and his people, which they are today clothed in white skin in America, who call themselves evangelical Christians. And so what does the Most High Yah want of me now and in this life? To present my body as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing and acceptable unto him. To give my life to him fully. To pursue his will and not the desires of my fleshly heart. But to give him my all of me. But without faith, he said, is it impossible to please him. Most High Yah, it is my desire to have the faith that will please you.
What is a sacrifice?
It is my desire to live my life that even Yahshua HaMashiach would do as he looks down upon me, as he rose at the stoning of the mighty man Stephen, proud of the life that he lived for you, serving you in humility, in love, appreciative of your grace and your mercy, but living in the fullness of the freedom that I have in my relationship with you due to the sacrifice that you gave to fulfill the law, to release love. So here is all of me, Yahshua. My life be an offering unto you and a sacrifice that is holy and pleasing and acceptable unto you. That at this moment and as my life carries on, Yah, you will be able to look down upon me as you look down upon your son and say, yes, that's one of my kids. And I'm proud. Because I'm honoring you, not just in my actions, but in the depths of my heart. That my heart will be pure, so that my hands and what they do will be to glorify you and serving those that are your precious, most glorious people. This video, and as I try with all my videos, is not to impress or be quote-unquote professional, but to be me. And tonight this song continues to minister to my spirit that that's what the Most High Yah, I believe, is calling us to, is to submit our lives, giving us our all to him. Not that those of you haven't already. So until we connect again, Shalom. And thank you for walking with me in this journey. For many of you who have also reached out to me saying you're in this same journey of understanding. Just want to be a man of faith. That I will be recognized by my faith my love and my devotion to Him and to His people, and presenting my life as an offering unto Him.